unsung heroes of our local communities often go through life unnoticed. That's why this year, for the very first time, Yours magazine has put together the Community Spirit Awards to recognise amazing Australians who are doing their bit for society. And our very own Ita is a judge this year. We're also joined by Rhonda, who is a volunteer from Central Coast Kids in Need. Guys, thanks for coming. Ita, let's start with you. What sort of people are being nominated this year?
Well, this is an award that recognise the contribution women over 50 make to the Australian community. So it could be a volunteer, it could be a carer, it could be a friend. You know, there's a lot of women doing great things, you know, and if we didn't have the women volunteers that we have in Australia, many of the services that people take for granted wouldn't exist at all.
And you obviously do so much, Ida, for various causes. What was special about this that made you decide to get involved?
Because it's for older women, recognising that. But primarily I have a lot of dealings with carers through my work with the various charities like Alzheimer's Australia, like Arthritis Australia and the Macular Disease Foundation. And I see the contribution they make to the services we deliver. We simply couldn't do them without their work.
Yeah.
Rhonda, you dedicate hours of your time. Tell us about the Central Coast Kids.
I'm treasurer for Central Coast Kids in Need. I have been for 12 years. And every year we support families from the coast who have sick children that have to travel to Sydney and Newcastle hospitals. Yeah. We support them with accommodation costs. We support them with travel costs. And of late, we also support them with high-cost prescriptions, quality of life equipment. And last year, I think we assisted 225 families and we outlaid $235,000.
That's
wow. And we're and we have a very small group of volunteers. Our committee is absolutely fantastic. There's only 15 of us.
Are you all women?
No, we have husbands that help, like mainly women, but husbands that help when we have any fundraising functions and things like that. But the everyday today things, I'm the treasurer. My sister Lorraine is the secretary. We have Louise, our president, and Joe, our vice president. And we only meet 3 times a year because it's just got too much for some of the younger people to get along.
Some of the younger ones?
Yes.
They don't meet people like they used to.
Rhonda, can I just ask you, know, you must have some very grateful families, but, you know, who's really struck a chord?
I had a family quite a few years ago that really affected me personally. The little girl was the same age as my granddaughter, who is now 9, and this little girl... she was only 3 when she had neuroblastoma and we had a lot to do with that family during that time and it affected me a lot because the little girl ended up passing away.
Oh dear.
She endured so much, but no matter when you'd see her, no matter what she was enduring, she'd always have a smile on her face. Always.
Amazing.
And the sickest of kids have smiles on their faces. You know, and this is sort of what encourages me to do what I do. I love kids. I've got 4 grandkids of my own. And this is my inspiration, just kids.
You're an inspiration.
Yeah. Thank you just for women like you.
Yeah, Rhonda, it's people like you who keep this world spinning and nominations are still open. So if you know someone who deserves to be recognised for the work they do in your community, head to our Facebook page to find out all the details. Thanks again for coming in.
Thank you.